Hey everyone, and welcome to the Gateless Gate with Sam Fisher. We're going over cone one, Joshi's dog today. It's probably the most important cone out there. But before we jump in, I'd like to ask you one burning important question. How far do you think you can go? How far do you think that you can go? You might be asking, well, Sam, I mean, what do you mean? How far do you think you can go? Where am I going? What do you mean? Well, I don't know. I don't know where you're going. You have to figure that out yourself. So you choose the direction. But my question to you is, how far do you think you can go in that direction? And maybe your answers will depending on the direction you choose. There's certainly some directions better than others. But let's say you went the right direction, whatever that one is for you. I don't think there's a limit. I don't think there's a limit to how far we can go. And that's crucial to understanding this cone, because what we see today is not the full picture of who we are tomorrow. And that all ties into this concept of mu. The way we see tomorrow is through mu. So this is what happens. A monk goes to Joshu, Master Joshu, Venerable Master Joshu, and he says, has the dog the Buddha nature? Joshu responds, mu, meaning, well, there's lots of definitions. Let's just get into the meaning. Mumon tries to explain it. He's like, it's not, is, not of, not, no, whatever. He's like, it's not no, but it is kind of no. It's the concept of saying that whatever was asked is not able to be answered. So when the monk came and said, does the dog have the Buddha nature? Joshu essentially said, that question is not in a form that can be answered truly. Please try again. Don't ask that question. Come up with a new question and try again. And the reason is because let's think about what a dog is. Or let's try answering the question, actually. Let's just try answering the monk's question. Does the dog have the Buddha nature? Well, we're falling into like a yes-no duality here, so let's just try it out, though. Let's say the dog does have the Buddha nature. Well, if the dog has the Buddha nature, why does it stink? Why does it have fleas? Why does it just sit there instead of doing stuff? Why is it going to die one day? And so, obviously, it does not have the Buddha nature. It's obviously missing something. But if you say, no, the dog does not have the Buddha nature, you run into another problem. Why is the dog alive? How can the dog have a relationship if it doesn't have any Buddha nature? What animates it if it isn't the Buddha nature? And so, we see here that Joshu is trying to help the monk understand that the question can't be truly answered with a yes or a no. And so he says, mu. He says, please unask your question and try again. And we get into this concept as well with Mumon. He says, like, you've got to realize that you've got to be, as you're going through this discipline, you've got to be what does he say? He says, like, you've got to swallow a ball, a hot burning ball, but you can't swallow it and you can't spit it up. It has to be in between the two areas. And so what we're trying to find in our devotion is to find this middle ground, this middle area where we're not on one side of the dark or the other, the dark or the light. That's not it. We're not in yin or yang, but we mediate between the two. And we mediate between the two by taking a step back, saying mu, and unasking the questions. And when we unask the questions, we can get into a deeper level of understanding. And when we get into a deeper level of understanding, we can ask new questions. And then when we ask those, we can say mu, unask those questions, and get to a deeper level of understanding. And so by this strange concept of mu, we can actually progress through all of the different things, all of the different levels, until we finally find the base level. We can act with reality as it truly is, as Mumon said in the preface. So I'm going to invite you to please uproot the inner workings of your mind. Take Mumon's challenge and begin to go through your life and try and get below the questions that are sent you. Try and unask the questions and the things you know today. And so I challenge you to roll back. Roll back your understanding and start trying to find reality as it truly is. So next one's Yakkajo's Fox, and we've got 47 other cones to go through. I'm really excited to do this with you, and we'll see you then.